In this video, some tips about using diodes, silicon or germanium. A silicon diode has a voltage drop from approximately 0.7 up to 0.8 volts, and that depends slightly on the applied voltage. Germanium, the voltage drop is approximately 0.3 volts. That also will slightly depend on the applied voltage. In this video, some tips, not about rectifiers or so, but more tips that could be handy in electronics. So, for applications, rectifier, well, watch many videos on YouTube and also videos on my YouTube channel where you can find one-phase rectifiers and other rectifiers, etc. A good application from such a diode could be an AC voltage limiter. When we send in here an AC voltage between 0 and 20 volts, the diode will cut off everything above 0.8 volts. In this case, for both phases from the signal, from the AC signal. So when you have here 20 volts or so, you will always find here a voltage from approximately 0.7 up to 0.8 volts. Of course, only when you use a silicon diode, and this could be a good choice for an experiment, the 1N5408. A quite sturdy silicon diode. But of course, when you connect two silicon diodes in a row and also two reverse silicon diodes in that same row, we find here a maximum voltage from approximately 1.4 volts, two times 0.7 volts or two times 0.8 volts. That depends somewhat. So it's a good circuit to safeguard, for instance, a sensitive electronic unit, that the voltage to that sensitive base from the transistor or the gate from a field effector sensor is safeguarded with the help of two anti-parallel diodes, or four of them. The second application is the so-called voltage dropper. I also use here, it's an advice, the 1N5408, because it's a sturdy diode. Every diode subtracts 0.7 or 0.8 voltage from the input voltage. So 18 volts in, and here 18 subtracted with 4 volts is 14 volts out. So the most simple circuit to drop a voltage from, say, 18 volts to 14 volts, or 12 volts to 4 volts lower, or whatever, 20 volts to 16 volts, etc. Very, very simple, and it always works, and use a sturdy diode for that application. This is the second page from the video. Another application is amplitude stabilization from an oscillator. That's of course very clear when you look at what I've told earlier. Two silicon diodes stabilize the amplitude to a maximum value, and four of them also stabilize the sine wave to a maximum value, and it can add a lot to the pureness from the sine wave. And with germanium, we have the same principles. So go to the video from the first point to now, and you can use the same principles, but use for your calculations approximately 0.3 volts. That has all to do with the properties from germanium.